ever been turned down? Have you ever been thrown out? Have you ever fought with your dad just to see what you was taught about? Have you ever had a dream that looked so easy and thought out? I sit up there, you just start out. Ain't no matter what, take the wrong route. Man, I'm just cruising. It's crazy how I breeze through the wind, but I'm losing. Old friends still asking why you do music. I tell them this is my therapy, it's therapeutic. And I like the way her shake to the music, see, ain't no problems. But all of my life, I feel I was chasing the dollar.
Lame, hey, it's Jersey the Rapper, aka Jersey the Giraffe. If you can call me what you want, but you can't call me lazy. And we back with another video. So I had to take a little time off from doing these videos because I had to get my stuff together. So we had to get equipment together. We had to get a whole bunch of stuff, y'all don't want to hear about, personal things. And we upgraded. We did a whole bunch of things. New spot, new crib, as you can see. New things coming soon. I wanted to use this platform just to show people, like, you could be a rapper, you could be a YouTube artist, you could do anything you want to do. You don't gotta just limit yourself to just being a rapper and you scared to show your life. Do it, bro. Don't care. First off, let me tell y'all what I'm about to start doing. I'm about to start telling different stories back in my life out in the hood when I moved to North Carolina from Jersey, doing all this shit, just crazy shit, man, just so y'all could come into the inside of my life. I'll be doing reactions, I'll be doing different type of things on this channel, I'll be doing everything, vlogs, going to different shows, different studios, working with different artists, just doing a whole bunch of the knowledge that y'all want to see me. So I want to tell y'all about the time I got jumped. Worst time of my life, it felt like. Like, I swear, it felt like it was the worst time of my life, bro. Nigga got jumped, got spent though. I'm from New Jersey. I'm from a small town in New Jersey called Irvington, New Jersey, but it's close to Newark, so we really just say we from Newark, New Jersey, and Irvington, New Jersey, bro, it's like the best. It's like both things, so it's like Irvington and Newark. It's like literally together, like, you don't ever separate them. So I'm from Irvington, Newark, New Jersey, basically. I spent my whole life in Irvington and Newark, so it's like, we got down here to North Carolina. My mom said we moving. I didn't believe my mom when she said we was moving because I had so many homeboys in New Jersey. I had so many, like, cool friends in New Jersey. So I was like, why are we leaving our family? Like, why would we even move down here? Like, we don't know nobody here, like, at all. Like, my mom had one friend here and we just moved here. We didn't know. So, like, when we got down here from New Jersey, I don't have no homeboys. All my homies back home, they mad. They're like, damn. Damn, Keon gone, shit, this shit crazy, keep going. And like, my homie Rich and everybody was mad, so it's whatever. But I get down here, to make a long story short, I'm like 14, 15 at the time. And like, my dad, he was going to this barbershop, but he always took me with me just so he could walk and show me like around, because we knew in North Carolina, so he was showing me different things, he was showing me places around. So he kept taking me to this barbershop when I was getting my haircut. Even when I wasn't getting my haircut, we was going there, we was getting different things, we was just chilling with the homies, watching the games, doing all. Then they asked me, I was like, Key, you wanna work up around here? You wanna work around here? I was sweeping hair and shit, like just sweeping hair, bro. Making about like $100, $200 a week, like just sweeping hair, bro, making good bread by myself, just making it $100. Like, when you 14, 15, that's a lot of bread, because you ain't paying no bills, you staying with your mom. Exactly. Time I told myself, bro, I'm gonna save up all this money, because, like, to flex at this school called 71st in North Carolina, like, they let you buy pizza and shit in high school. So I'm thinking, I'm like, damn. You could buy pizza and shit in high school. So, like, in order for you to be flexing, you gotta buy, like, a whole bunch of pizzas. Like, big boxes of pizzas. Like, you buy, if you buy, like, two boxes of pizzas and sit them on the cafeteria stand and you sit right there with all that and you give them out, everybody come to your table. Slab Jersey got all the pizza, all the girls got all the pizza. But then, okay, I saved up all my money and I end up doing it, right? And everybody was watching me. That was the most stupidest thing I ever did.
You stupid.
So them just watching me. Kept coming up to me, just these niggas was in the corner while I was buying my pizza. When I was buying my pizza, they just kept looking at me and staring at me in the corner. And I had like these tight pants on, I remember. And my wallet was poking out. I don't know why I was wearing that type of stuff when I was 15. It was so crazy. I was wearing like these tight pants on that could show my breast. So like when I pulled out my money, it was kind of hard. So I was just trying to pull out my junk. I didn't have no wallet, bro. I really just had like this clip thing that my cousin gave me, like when I left Jersey. It was like this clip, this money clip, and I had about like $2.50 in there. But I used to always get like smaller bills, so it looked like I got a whole stack. So when I come up into the lunch line, I should have never did that.
You stupid.
Never. So it was like three of these dudes, and I know two of these dudes, they from New York, and one of them from here. So they came up to me or whatever. They just came up to me. I was like, what's up, bro? How you? I see you got all that pizza. Just kept looking at it. I was like, yeah, he got mad bread. And as a kid, I'm thinking like, because people play like this all the time. And I seen these dudes before, like Jersey. I'm like, yeah, I'm from Jersey. So yeah, you know what I mean? They from New York or whatever, so it's like best of both worlds. I was like, they ain't on that type of time because they from North Carolina. Don't ever underestimate nobody, no matter where they from. I learned that. These dudes show, I'm just dapping them up or whatever, and I go to class or whatever, not minding that these dudes just keep following me. Like, yo, they keep following me, just looking at me. So I get to the class, I get to my fourth period, and then my fourth, at gym. We're changing outside the dressing room, and he was like, bro, come to my house, bro, I got the studio set up. I want you to learn how to start rap. This around the first time where I was just getting my name up and trying to rap. So I was learning how to rap at Jay Carter's little mic set up or whatever. I was trash, completely trash, not good. And my first fucking rap name was K-Skills. So I'm not knowing that this dude that I know in my fourth period, we're gonna call him Jay. Like, I didn't know Jay stayed in the ops hood. Like, he stays in the ops hood. I can't make this up, but I'm not knowing. So like, I'm just going, I'm in. I got my freaking like little Android, and when I was running out of Wi-Fi, I just like screenshotted the direction so I could just go to his hood. So when I went to his hood, I took like his house first. I knocked on the door and he wasn't there. So that was the first sign that made me realize, like, okay, yeah. When I got to Jay house, like, I was going in directions that he showed me and stuff like that. When I got to the directions that Jay and him showed me, I got my bike and I went on the porch and I knocked on the door like 8 times and he wasn't there. He was not there. So he wasn't there. So I end up getting mad or whatever because I had all my money on me or whatever, you know what I'm saying? So I hopped my bike back over the fence and I was going back over and he hit my phone and he was like, yo, I'm at this house. It's 2 blocks around and it's a better studio. So I'm like, hey, so okay, cool. We about to go to a better studio in the hood. So I was like, shit, it's only 2 blocks around the corner. So me hopping over the shortcut, I'm not knowing. Bro, the whole time, the shortcut is the ops backyard, bro. That's they backyard. Literally, that's the ops house backyard. The ones that see me at school asking me about my bread, keep following me and shit. So I'm like, look behind you. I'm like, behind you? What the fuck they mean look behind me or whatever? So I look behind me, and it's the niggas from school. So they like, oh, what up, bro? What up, bro? They was on some cool. They was like, what up, bro? What up, bro? Out of nowhere, this nigga just steal off on me, bro. Bro just said, he took my bike, threw my shit. And I'm like, bro, I thought it was cool. Like, I'm thinking we cool, bro. Whole time, I'm thinking we cool. These niggas just start wilding on me. So I'm tussling, whatever, I'm backing up. These niggas got me on the floor. Hell, like, but you know, when you mad and you start crying and shit, like, nigga, what the fuck? And we start fighting on some shit like that. So then, long story short, when them niggas popping me out, they stomping me out and shit, they just going crazy, beating my ass, bro. And I can't even do nothing. I'm like, one nigga from my hood that fucks with some of the niggas from to where I just moved at, he was like, yo, what y'all doing? What y'all doing? What y'all doing? Get off him. So he had to play. He was like, bro, what the fuck are you doing over here? Get the fuck from around here. I promise you, I'm leaving my shit all swolled up. My junk mad swolled up. I'm just like bleeding. I'm mad swolled up because it was at least like 6-7 of them. One of them tackled me, like 4 or 5 of them just start stomping my shit. All face shots just start stomping my shit. So I'm like, all right, they got that. It's 6 of them. All right, cool. And one dude never was to say nothing, I would have been straight. If you went and amped up the whole situation and was like, bitch, I want what's in your pockets. Bitch, I want what's in your pocket. They would have been straight. You know what I'm saying? But he wanted to be on some tough ass nigga shit and get all his niggas instead of trying to like take it himself because he knew I was gonna beat his ass. I'm like, alright, that's cool. So we're gonna call this dude named C. We're gonna call C Look. So I get to school and all these dudes go to school with me, so I'm mad. Like, they didn't get nothing from me though. It's crazy, like, yeah, I forgot. They didn't get nothing from me though. Like, I end up getting my wallet because they end up like in the midst of me fighting. I was like all over the place, so they couldn't get in my pocket. So anytime I tried to get in my pocket, I was just beating that shit off. Like, you just can't get in my pocket. I was like, I need this bread for the end of the week, cause how I'm gonna get to school and shit like that. But I'm just fucked up. Like, these niggas had my whole face fucked up, so it just beat. I can't go to school the next day cause I'm lumped up. I'm like, these niggas ain't gonna get the best of this shit. Nah, fuck you. A long time ago, so I'm trying to put it together, so just bear with me. I'm mad at the fact that these dudes followed me all day, that they didn't announce they so. They basically plotted on me and I didn't know that they was the op, but it was this one dude who kept amping up the situation. We're gonna call him C. When I get to school, I'm gonna fuck C up, period. And I let the word be known, like, yeah, I'm gonna ask, bro, you tried to jump me in your hood, bro, and I wanna see all this shit too, all the tough shit you was saying. So, C at school, but mind you, I went to school trying to fight. Just period. I just went to school trying to fight. I didn't have no football bag. I didn't have nothing. I just had some sweatpants on, a t-shirt, and I was like, let's go. I'm ready to fight. So I told all these in my hood, or all on my bus. We used to call that hoods back in the day. And you know, in high school, your hood is the one on the bus from down here. That's how it was down here. So when I got to school, I didn't see him until like lunchtime. So lunchtime, I was like, cause I always see him at lunchtime, and I knew, cause that's the time they spotted me with that piece of shit. So I knew, I was like, I'm gonna see his ass at lunchtime. So I was like, cool, when I catch your ass, it's gonna be smoke. But he had all his niggas with him at lunchtime. So I was like, cool. Ooh. So in 71st, it's divided in different hallways. They got like 700 hallways, 300 hallways, 600 hallways. And the different hallways, and the hallway the lunch hall was on, is like, as soon as you walk inside the building, it's a cafeteria, and it's a bathroom right here where everybody go to like brawl it out. Let's go scrap it out. You know, everybody go in the bathroom and brawl with it, right? So after I ate, after lunch, I didn't eat, mind you. Like, I wasn't in school to do nothing. Like, I was planning on going there. Whatever happens, if I lose, win, or draw, I'm gonna fight these dudes. Cause like, I let it go on for like 4 days, bro, without telling nobody. But everybody kept laughing at me because they was making jokes or whatever, like, yeah, we ran up on him, like, and I was like, and mad people kept coming up and telling me that they was saying that, and like, they was laughing or whatever, but it kind of got to me, and I was like, it was bad. It made me feel kind of bad about myself sometimes. I don't know why, like, I just had to accomplish it. It just felt like, mind you, they was like, kept looking and just kept picking or whatever, and I ain't no PWO, like, I ain't, mind you, I'm from the hood, like, I'm not no, it's like, period, I can fight, like, period, I can fight. Don't get it twisted, but when it's six of them, bro, it's kind of outnumbered, whatever, but I'm still a wolf. Like, I'm still gonna fight regardless. Hands down, win the draw, we gonna throw this. Like, I don't care, you know what I'm saying? That I wanna scrap, oh, but in the bathroom, I'll be waiting right now, because it was towards the end of lunch. It was like 10 minutes left, so the administrators wasn't gonna be out there. So I was like, bet we could get this brawl going, and we gonna get it done, and I'm gonna finish this. I don't wanna be cool after. I wanna smoke with you and your homeboys, because that wasn't called for, and that wasn't cool. And they knew they could've just scrapped me one-on-one, each of y'all, and I would've gave y'all the feeling. So, we was in the bathroom, I was waiting on him, but his girlfriend was outside the door holding him back, like, don't go. He was ready to go, so I was like, let's go, I'm gonna knock your teeth out, boy. I was standing out the door, I was like, I'm gonna knock your teeth out for sure. Like, I was like, I'm pissed, I'm red, mad niggas gotta hold me back, cause I was like, I'm just gonna steal on this nigga in the hallway, cause I'm not. He was like, bet they all kept, like, I didn't see him at school, I only seen them at lunchtime, and some of them didn't come to school, so I don't care who's there, whatever, I'm just gonna die. Let's go, we gonna fight. I'm already on 10, so like, long story short, back to the story, I mean. We walking down this hallway, I say like the 100 hallway, but like you gotta go back to your classroom, and it's like this little breezeway, and it's like a brick wall right here, but it's like open field right here, but with no windows. So, and it's like outside, so we go out this way. Everybody walking back, it's like a crowded ass hallway. Everybody walking back, I'm walking through the breezeway after I just told them, I was like, you, after they was holding me back and we was having that whole little debacle and we was like arguing whatever, I was like, yo, you a all this, you know what I mean, at the door, and I'm like, I'm ready to knock you out, and I was like loud, and everybody got silent, and I just was like, I'm gonna knock you the freak out, yeah, I'm not playing, and then everybody was like, whoo, and then I walked off, so he got real mad at that time, and then he was behind me, so I was like, bet, I'm walking, whatever, and then all I hear somebody be like, yo, Jersey, look out, he got one hit off, he hit me in the back of my head, right, he just, boom, I'm like, bet, it's on the cracker, let's go.
Man, I'm just cruising. It's crazy how I breeze through the wind, but I'm losing. Old friends still asking why you do music. I tell them this is my therapy, it's therapeutic.
And so after he hit me in the back of my head, I'm like, let's go, let's go. So I ball up my fist or whatever. I hit this man. Boom. All rights. I'm literally hitting this man with all rights. I couldn't get my left arm out. I was just using it to block my face because he rushed me. So when I turned around after he hit me in the back of my head, I'm like, let's go. I'm tapping the back. Tapping him back, and then I just followed through with like two good ones. Busted his lip with the first one. Second one, I hit him again, and then he felt a little stomach dip. Third one, I dropped his ass, but mind you, it was slippery outside. I hit his ass, and when I dropped him, I fell too, but he was like, I went on top of him, like, and I just started punching him. His homeboy got him off, got me off of him, and just punched him. And I was like, bet him too. So I'm just swinging, but I'm not swinging at the other dude. The other dude jumped out the way. I'm swinging back at him, and I hit again. And then I walked up because all my homeboys grabbed me, like, you won, keep going, bro, you won. And I'm like, nah, just beat me up. These niggas jumped me, bro. I had my face looking lumpy for a couple days. I was pissed. So then He come by the door again, he followed me again, he rushed me again, but this time he hit me like in the back of my neck because he couldn't reach the top of the back of my head, so he hit me back of my neck. I'm like, I bet. So it's slippery right here. This time I hit him again. I ducked his punch and I hit him again, and then he slipped, he fall, he busts his ass, nose bleeding this time. I'm like, yes, this is what I wanted. I kept hitting his ass with my legs, and the administrator pushed me off them, and he pushed me hard as shit. He hit me to the door, and I was like, damn, bro, that shit, it hurt. So then my teacher, like this lady named Miss Toby, like she loved me, bro. She used to put me, like she put me up and helped me like throughout school or whatever, my science teacher. She put me in her class on 10, just mad as shit. Couldn't breathe, whole class full of students, mind you. I'm embarrassed walking in there, my hands bleeding like shit. And I'm like, ugh. She keeps trying to help me not get in trouble. And I'm like, man, nah, fuck this. So I went back in the hallway, and I was like, man, fuck this. I'm mad as hell. So I went to the bathroom, I'm already mad and whatever. I got called to the office, cause you know you get called to the office for fighting or whatever. He iced his lip or whatever, and it was like, yo, what happened? I didn't say nothing. I didn't feel like writing no statement or nothing like that. I'm still mad. And I told him, I was like, I'll bring this man in his office. I'm gonna beat his ass again, bro, after what he did. Cause I'm already mad. Dumbass outside, C, said that he wanted what was in my pockets. So they suspended his ass, and I didn't get suspended because I didn't say nothing. I didn't write nothing on the thing. I just told him that I was defending myself. That's it. He came up, he punched me first. Like, that's how it went. I was defending myself. Yeah. I'm saying. So I get back to school the next day, cause I got back the next day, nigga. I'm getting all this praise, everybody. His niggas came up and bumped me or whatever. They kept following me around school cause I made him look stupid in front of the whole school. I beat his ass in front of the whole lunchroom. So just imagine. So I end up not getting in trouble or whatever, and I end up coming back to school. And when I come back to school, everybody like praising me and all this. Like, okay, cool, that's whatever, whatever. I'm all sore cause I done fought. Like, I start feeling the effects of the fight after, whatever, you know what I mean? I still got the mark to this day on my fist right here when I hit his teeth. But it really ain't no smoke today and nothing like that with whoever it is, because we end up having a class together after that, and I end up seeing his brother. We end up chopping it up, talking about it and different things like that. I end up having to go to court. I caught a whole charge over that shit. Even though I didn't get suspended at the school, and down in North Carolina, they have sheriffs at the school, and the sheriffs, it took him so much to break us up. Like, it break me up because, now I'm saying, it was so much smoke throughout the whole day, because I was going to end up fighting his brother too, because I ended up seeing a whole bunch of mess, and the sheriff wasn't going for it. He was being a whole, you know what, and I wasn't even trying to go for it neither. So, but he said he ain't dropping the charges, so I had to keep going to court every Thursday reporting like it was on some probation type joint. It was so annoying, bro. The lady kept calling me until I was 18, until my birthday. Every birthday she kept calling me after 8 o'clock. It was too much. Saying I don't promote violence. Protect yourself though. Always protect yourself, bro. In a defensive situation, always protect yourself. Be smart. It ain't dumb or lame or nothing like that to stay out the way, get your money and just hoop. Do what you do. You know what I mean? We're gonna be back with another video. This is it for now. We're gonna make a bunch of stories, we're gonna make a bunch of history, more vlogs and more stuff coming soon. New album, new everything on the way. Lame Jersey, we out.